everybody, and welcome to my first video. Today, I'm going to be showing you how to tame your hamster. This is Willow. He is a Russian dwarf hamster. I've had him for about 2 weeks. He is very shy of hands, and he has bit me. While I wait for him to wake up, I'm going to tell you some important things you need to know when taming your hamster. The first important thing you need to know when taming your hamster is when you have your hand in your hamster's cage, you need to make sure you move very slowly. You don't want to startle your hamster. The second thing you need to know when taming your hamster is you need to have something your hamster wants. It could be some treats or some seeds from its mix. It needs to be something your hamster likes, so your hamster is interested when you put your hand in its cage and it wants to come to you. The third thing you need to know is you have to be patient. All hamsters will tame at a different speed, and just because yours is taming very slowly, it doesn't mean that he's not going to tame. You have to be patient with your hamster. The fourth thing you need to know when taming your hamster is you always should wash your hands. It's very important that your hands don't smell like food or your hamster will bite you. You also shouldn't use scented soap, especially soap that smells like food, like pomegranate scented soap, which is what happened to me. I washed my hands with pomegranate scented soap, and he bit my finger because he thought it was food. So it's very important you use unscented soap so your hamster can easily tell the difference between the food and your fingers. Now I'm going to tell you what to do if your hamster bites you. Hamsters don't bite often, but if they feel threatened, they can bite. The first thing you need to do if your hamster bites you is stay calm and just slowly take your hand out of his cage. You don't want to make your hamster more scared. The second thing you need to do if your hamster bites you is make sure you don't do what you were doing when your hamster bit you again, because your hamster didn't like that. That's why your hamster bit you. It felt threatened and didn't like what you were doing, so it was telling you to stop by biting you. The third thing you need to do if your hamster bites you is give your hamster some time alone. You should probably try and avoid the room your hamster's in as much as possible. Now I'm going to talk a little bit about cages and wheels. Your hamster needs a minimum of 450 square inches of floor space. This is very important for your hamster. I would recommend getting a bin cage. This is what I have here. My friend Emma made a video on how to make a bin cage, so I will link that in the description. A Syrian hamster needs an 8-inch wheel at the smallest, and a dwarf hamster needs a 6-inch wheel at the smallest. I would recommend getting, like, probably even an 8-inch wheel for your dwarf and an 8.5-inch wheel for your Syrian, because it can cause them back problems if they have too small of a wheel. Another thing about wheels is you should never get your hamster mesh or bar wheels. You should always get them solid wheels like this. Right here I have a flying saucer. It's solid, so the hamster can't get its feet stuck in the holes. Mesh and bar wheels can be very dangerous for your hamster, so I would recommend getting a silent spinner or even here a flying saucer. Wheels like that are solid, so your hamster's feet can't fall through the holes. Now I'm going to talk a bit about bedding and food. Right here I have Carefresh. I would not recommend this bedding because it's too dense for your hamster to burrow in. I have this here. This is the first bedding I got and my hamster couldn't burrow in it. Now I switched to the Katie Clean and Cozy. It also expands 3 times, so it's like way more. This is like $30 and this is like $20. So I would recommend this. It's way more fluffy and it's softer. It's way better for your hamster. Right here I have my hamster's food. As you can see, it's got some corn, some seeds, some peanuts. It's really important that your hamster gets a good variety of things in its food. If your hamster's food doesn't have a lot of things, you can add some stuff in, like oats and flax seeds. I only add in some oats, and that's pretty much mostly what I add in because it's got quite a few things. I also add in some fresh food. Now I'm going to go ahead and get my hamster's food ready for him. Now I've gone and taken most of the shells of his seeds out. It's kind of hard to pick through, so this is what I got out. I have a piece of clean washed lettuce right here. I'm not going to give him all of this because it's too much. I'm going to give him about half. You need to always make sure you wash your fresh food you give your hamster.
Now that I have my hamster's food, I'm going to go through here and I'm just going to take a bit of a scoop, put it in here so we get some more variety of things. There we go. Now I'm going to put that in his cage. As you can see, my hamster has woken up, so now I'm going to start taming.
So right now I just have a seed from a seed mix and I'm going to give it to him. I'm going to make sure I move my hand very slowly and put it in over here and let him come to it. Here you go, Willow. If he's not interested, then that's okay. You need to wait. See, he's not interested right now. He might not see it because hamsters don't have good vision, so I'm going to slowly move it closer till he sees it, and he took it. Now I'm just going to walk away and sit down and watch him.
Thank you everybody so much for watching this video. Please go subscribe to my friend Emma. She does lots of really awesome videos about her pets. And bye!